Hi, this is a channel about exploring new and fun ways of learning and teaching maths worldwide. This is my first episode in English. Yay! So I asked myself, why not do something international? And there's a saying that Asians are better in math, right? I'm not sure, so let's explore. I made a basic research in Google and found three international results. First, the PISA. PISA is the Program for International Student Assessment. Second, the IMO, International Mathematical Olympiad. And third is the Fields Medal. It's the Fields Medal. And it's like the Nobel Prize for math, because Nobel Prize doesn't have a math prize. Okay, let's see. And actually, PISA is a research and an assessment to the 15-year-old students' performance on math, science, and reading. Let's focus on math. And you can see that starting from the first place is China, Singapore, Macau, Hong Kong, Taiwan, Japan, and South Korea. So all the top sevens are all Asians. And we can scroll down and see the UK is in the 17th place, 20th is Germany, 25th France, and the US is in the 37th. So it seems that the saying could be true. Asians are better in math. Let's draw some conclusion afterwards. Let's turn to IMO. This is the usnews.com, and it listed the five countries that have the best results in IMO. And which are the five countries? Iran, the US, Vietnam, China, and South Korea. So basically, the Asian countries are the South Korea, China, and Iran. Vietnam and Iran. Seems like most of them are Asians. And there are some more results in the IMO in the Wikipedia. And you can see that in this chart it listed the highest team score every year. I mean, which nation scored the highest in every year. And this is the record. And you can see from these charts, there are the China, Russia, Hungary, US, Romania, Germany, Bulgaria, Iran, and South Korea. Seems to me it's like a tie, because the numbers are about the same for Asians and the Westerners. Unfortunately, that only shows the top places countries. That means only first place countries. And actually, I can click through the IMO official page, but I don't want to click them one by one by the country category. So I don't go through that much in detail. And the third result is the Fields Medal. Actually, the Fields Medal goes to the mathematicians contributing a lot to the math research field. So they are not only counting numbers, they are exploring new math tools for us human beings to use. For other fields like natural sciences and computer sciences, economics and finance. And so many other applications. It's like the Asian countries are gone. There are three from Japan, and two from Iran, and then some more, and then one from China and one from Vietnam. The US, France, and Russia really dominate the Fields medals. From these three results, it seems to me that Asians could be better in middle to even high school, but not as good in the math research field. So, are they really good in math? To me, the answer is no. What they are really good in is this: the arithmetic. So So, what arithmetic is about? It's about the addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of numbers. So how can I infer from those international middle or high schooler results that Asians are better in arithmetic? Because most of the regular middle to high schooler math curriculum is about arithmetic. You will say, no, we have equations, exponentials, logarithms, trigonometries, differentiation, and integration. And I would say, yes, in the deepest sense, they are all arithmetic in the way it is taught. How is that so? Because in the deepest sense, arithmetic addresses those how-to questions. That means you just need to follow through the instructions and get the result without knowing why. For example, did you ask why a to the m times a to the n equals a to the m plus n? Why is this still true for rational numbers, m and n? And why is this still true for reals? And how about imaginary numbers? Most of the time, we don't know why, okay? You just need to remember the formula. At least most of the Asians did that, okay? But the real math addresses those why questions. So it needs more rigorous proofs. That's the differences between arithmetic and math. And of course, that's the word 算术 and 数学. In Cantonese, it's like 算术,数学. And in Japanese, they have this divided into two categories. But actually, many Asians don't really know the differences between arithmetic and mathematics. So many of them just know, oh, I'm good in mathematics, but actually, they are good in arithmetic more. Okay, and maybe you have another question. But I do have loads of proof questions. There are real math, right? Some of the Asians do good in IMO too. So I would say, yes, you're right. I have no rebuttals now. Because that's another story. And part of the reason could be Asians are better in exams. But that could be another YouTube episode, I guess. So the question now is why Asians are better in arithmetic? And my answer is language. So take Chinese and Japanese as example. Actually, we shared the same words. I'm from Hong Kong, so I use Cantonese, and Cantonese and Mandarin just use the same Chinese words. And also, Japanese do use these kind of words too. It's called Hanzi in Cantonese or Hanzi in Mandarin. And I guess it's also the same meaning in Japanese. So, what I want to say is that in Cantonese, these 10 numbers are called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And in Mandarin, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In Japanese, it's called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, but what's good in the Asian languages comes afterwards. Like if you want to say 11, you combine a 10 and a 1, and you can see that the characters also combine together and form this 11. It is called 十一 in Cantonese, because it's a 10 combining with a 10 is a 十, and 1 is a 一. And so this is called 十一. And similarly, in Mandarin is 十一. In Japanese is 十一. So what's next after this 11? The 12, 13, and 14, and so on, is called 十一, 十二, 十三, 十四, 十五, 十六, 十七, 十八, 十九. And 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And in Japanese is 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 18, 19, and that's 11 to 19 in the corresponding languages. So, is it as easy for English-speaking children to infer from the pronunciations of the words to the math meaning? It's not as easy. In 11 and 12, you can see that I can't directly know that it's a 10 and a 1 and a 10 and a 2 in these two words. And 13 and 15 are better, because I know better that there's a 3 here and there's a 5 here. But actually, these are called the ordering words. Like the 3rd is like the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. It's another numbering system about the orders. It's not the counting words like 1, 2, 3. Like this is not called 13, it's called 13. And this is called 15 instead of 15. So there's a difference in the, you know, the ordering words like 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and 5th, and 6th, and so on. And so there are some difficulties here too. And then 14, 16, and up to 19 are better, because I can refer as 6 here, and then 10, you can refer it to as 10, and it's called 16. But there are two more difficulties. I can point it out, like 16. How can I write 16? It's like the 1 first, and then the 6. So this is how I write the Arabic numbers. But this one, the 1 is like a 10, and this is 6 is called is also referring to 6. But the problem about 16 is that I will think about the 6 first and then the 10 afterwards. So it's like reversing the order of the meaning when I am thinking about the number. I guess the children also have this kind of problem, I guess. And then the second difficulty is about 20, 30, and 40, and so on. Because I have to remember a new word for every 10 new numbers. Like, you have to remember this 20 to pronounce 21, and 22, and so on, to 29. But in Chinese and Japanese, we don't have to do so. Like, if you want to if you want to pronounce 45, it's like 4, 10, 5. Then the work is done. Yes, and that is how Asian languages are better to suit the dannery system. If I have to talk it professionally, it's called the dannery system. That means the 10 number system. English is better in terms of this fits in system as compared to French, because the French also have a different system called the sexagesimal system. That is the 60 number system. And what it means is that for the unit digit, for every 60, only until 60, you carry the value into the tens digit. But in the 10 number system that we most often use, every 10 in the unit digit will be carried over to the next digit, and every 10 in the next digit will be carried over to the next digit. And that's how all the Asian languages, if not all, can be, you know, directly fits in to the number system that we use nowadays. So one more thing I want to stress on is that the language power amplifies along the learning curve. Take addition as an example. This table shows how you add together two single digit numbers. And of course, if you want to add more digits, like two digit numbers to two digit numbers, then you are just like repeated doing this single digit number additions. So, what I want to say is that, yeah, as a math devoted learner and a teacher also over 20 years, what I know about kids is like they want to speak the what they are learning and what they're reading out loud, and of course a teacher also make them to do it so also. But like in additions, you can see as in this table, the red numbers are the ones in the lower right hand corner, and these are the numbers that you could get results greater than or equal to 10. So those are the numbers that carried over the value. What I mean is that the unit digit, when you get a 10, then it moves to, and it, the values are carried over to the next digit by, and you get a 1 in the 10th digit. So, like half of the time, when you are doing additions of single digit numbers, you will get something problematic, because I have already told you that those numbers after the tens are the really problematic ones. Especially, you can see that 11 and the 12 are the evil ones, and you can see there are 8 of them 11s, and then 7 of them are 12. So, like, you can, I can roughly say that, like, half of the time when you are a first time learner of additions, then you will get some trouble when you're using English to speak out what you are doing in additions. So that's the problem in learning additions, of course. And how about multiplication? So we can see that in this table is all the numbers getting two single digit numbers to multiply together. So you can see that around, like, there are like 17 of them who are in between 10 and 19. And you can see the evil word, the 12, comes with a frequency of 4. It's the most, and it is like the same as 6 and 18. They all get 4 result from this single digit times single digit number. And as you can see, like 17 of them are like between 10 and 19, the problematic ones. So it's like around, there are 81 of them here in all the results. So it's around like 20% of the time, the first time learner may get confusing when you are doing multiplications. So as a result, like, additions, that addition table that I showed you before, and that this multiplication table that I show you now, these are the most important thing for additions and multiplications, even for like more digits, more digit numbers. When you're multiplying, you know, the three digit number with a two digit number or three digit numbers, then, you know, the difficulty may amplify. But if you are using English, then it's like more difficult because of what I've told you. And so that's why I'm telling you that the language power can amplify throughout. And you can see that when you are using an Asian language, the problem may be a little fewer, I guess. So that's all I want to say about, like, why Asians are better in arithmetic. And of course, there are also other reasons, and that's not the full picture, because I've told you that they are better in preparing exams, and there are some certain exam skills and also arithmetic skills that help them to become better for like the university entrance exams and so on. I hope I do explain something for you, and if you don't agree with me or whatever, you can always comment below. If you like the video, please comment, like, and share. And thank you. Welcome, and see you next time.